of earth to love come down. Hidden here, the humble dwelling, all thy faithful mercies crown. Jesus, out of all compassion, your unbounded love thou art. Purify us with thy salvation. Almighty to deliver, let us all thy life receive. Suddenly return and nevermore thy temples leave. Always blessing.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. A very good morning, everyone. We come together on this, the 25th Sunday of Ordinary Time, and we ask the Lord to help us break open the Word and break bread together. Yesterday, at the vigil mass, of course, the singing was so bad, we had a thunderstorm. Don't tell them I said that. No, honestly. It clears the air and waters the earth. So we ask the Lord to be with us, especially keep those safe who are driving today. Would you like to be seated for a moment? And I'd like to invite our children forward for children's liturgy. Would you like to come forward? Any children who'd like to join Kirsty this morning? Okay, do you want to come forward? Okay, hi. All right, I like your stronger than you think. Okay. Come forward. Can you just stand up here for me and turn around? The other way to the people. And your t-shirt says, stronger than I think. That's quite a good thing, isn't it? So when you look in the mirror, you say, I'm stronger than I think. I'm definitely stronger than I look. What do you think? Okay, take a seat. Okay. Right, so we ask the Lord to be with us and that you learn about Jesus and the good news of Jesus Christ. And so we ask the Lord to be with you. Dear Lord, come upon our children and guide them and watch over them today. Be with them and their catechists as they learn the good news of Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You kept putting your arms out, thinking you loved me and you wanted a hug, but you just want the book, don't you? Yeah, okay then. All right. Have a good time, children. Okay. It's nice to be wanted. Shall we stand? To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. And we ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. I'd like to be seated for the Word of God.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The godless say to themselves, "Let us lie in wait for the virtuous man, since he annoys us and opposes our way of life, reproaches us for our breaches of the law, and accuses us of playing false to our upbringing. Let us see if what he says is true. Let us observe what kind of end he himself will have. If the virtuous man is God's son, God will take his part and rescue him from the clutches of his enemies. Let us test him with cruelty and with torture, and thus explore this gentleness of his and put his endurance to the proof. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, since he will be looked after. We have his word for it." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord upholds my life.
The Lord upholds my life.
O God, save me by your name. By your power, uphold my cause. O God, hear my prayer. Listen to the words of my mouth.
The Lord upholds my life.
For proud men have risen against me. Ruthless men seek my life. They have no regard for God.
The Lord upholds my life.
But I have God for my help. The Lord upholds my life. I will sacrifice to you with willing heart and praise your name, for it is good.
The Lord upholds my life.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Wherever you find jealousy and ambition, you find disharmony and wicked things of every kind being done. Whereas the wisdom that comes down from above is essentially something pure. It also makes for peace and is kindly and considerate. It is full of compassion and shows itself to be good, doing good. Nor is there any trace of partiality or hypocrisy in it. Peacemakers, when they work for peace, sow the seeds which will bear fruit in holiness. Where do these wars and battles between yourselves first start? Isn't it precisely in the desires fighting inside your own selves? You want something and you haven't got it, so you are prepared to kill. You have an ambition that you cannot satisfy, so you fight to get your way by force. Why you don't have what you want is because you don't pray for it. When you do pray and don't get it, it is because you have not prayed properly. You have prayed for something to indulge your own desires. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Anyone who follows me will have the light of life.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. After leaving the mountains, Jesus and his disciples made their way through Galilee, and he did not want anyone to know, because he was instructing his disciples. He was telling them, "The Son of Man will be delivered into the hands of men. They will put him to death, and 3 days after he has been put to death, he will rise again." But they did not understand what he said and were afraid to ask him. They came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the road?" They said nothing, because they were arguing which one of them was the greatest. So he sat down, called the 12 to him, and said, "If anyone wants to be first, he must make himself last of all and servant of all." He then took a little child, set him in front of them, put his arms around him, and said to them, "Anyone who welcomes one of these little children in my name welcomes me. And anyone who welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord. Would you like to be seated? A very good morning, everyone. We welcome any visitors we have. I forgot to say that at the very beginning of Mass today. You're most welcome if you're visiting sunny Matlock today. When we think about living our lives and we think about corporate companies and even small corner shops and butchers and bakers and candlestick makers, they, of course, the businesses get passed on from one generation to the next. They get passed on by their families from father to daughter or father to son. But we know that if you have a company and you just wait until your son or your daughter finishes university and then give them a place on the board in a corporate world, or give them the keys to the shop and give them a management position, we know that they will have no wisdom about how to run business. They will have no humility about what it feels like for the members of staff who work there. So most people who own businesses will ask their sons or daughters to start maybe in the mail room or at the back of the shop where some of the hard work is done. They will start on the shop floor, and they will not be humiliated, but they will discover humility and wisdom and what it is to work alongside others. If we want to make somebody wise, maybe we should get them to stack cans of soup in Tesco's with the old pricing gun. Do you remember that? And of course, because why would I say that? Because you are forced then to talk to the general public, to find humility in people above you, directing you. We all have to start when we're younger in a lower place, because we have to gain that wisdom. We have to gain that humility and service. When I was left school at 16 in 1986, I know that's so long ago, 1986, I did an apprenticeship, a watchmaking apprenticeship. I'm a horologist by trade. But I didn't start the job and suddenly was able to repair watches. This was a two-year course just to learn the basics. And half of that time was finding me standing next to somebody else, watching them how they repaired watches and how they cleaned it and how they cared for and repaired them. I wasn't allowed to stand with my hands in my pockets. My back was sore sometimes. They used to send me for things like buckets of steam and long weights and left-handed screwdrivers. And I, as a 16-year-old, I would go and fetch them. And of course, it's really important that I was immersed in the humility of knowing what it is to be 16, to be an apprentice, to learn the ropes, but also to become thicker skinned and to know what it is to talk to an adult in the workplace. All of these things, without realizing it, start to shape us in life. If we think that when we leave university, we know everything, then we've learned nothing, isn't it? Jesus, in today's gospel, is a rabbi. He's a different kind of rabbi, and he's a teacher, and he is teaching, and he's showing them that he is the Son of God. He's teaching, he's healing, there's miracles happening, and they are following him. Some were John the Baptist's disciples who left John the Baptist to follow Jesus. Jesus called others to him. There was 12 apostles and many other disciples around him, following him. But in today's gospel, it says that Jesus took them, they were touring around Galilee, but he took them into a private place so that he could start teaching them the importance of being a disciple, the importance of being an apostle. He started to teach them that who he was, and he would be arrested, and he would be put to death, and on the third day he would rise again. But because their hearts and their minds were not open to the Spirit at that point, they did not understand what he was talking about and were too afraid to ask. So they weren't open to the good news. They weren't open to the Spirit. They weren't open to God's message. And why were they not open? Because they were just normal human beings. And instead, when they walked along the road with Jesus, when Jesus was up ahead maybe, they would argue with one another, who was the most important? I'm the most important because I'm his favorite. I hold the purse strings. Maybe I should lead us after he's gone. No, I'm the rock. I've been chosen. I should lead. And of course, this vanity, this hunger for power is a human trait. And Jesus knew this of them. So when he stopped them when they came to Capernaum, one of the great cities, a great city where there's lots of course, people and power and influence and sin and debauchery as well. Jesus asked them in the heart of that city, what were you talking about on the road? And Jesus knew what they were talking about, but of course the right answer for Jesus would have been, we heard what you said and we're going to meditate upon it and we're going to become great disciples and model our lives on you. But that's not what they said. They hung their heads with embarrassment because they had learned nothing as his disciples. Nothing, because they were not open. And Jesus then, of course, knew what they were talking about. So he brought a little child next to him. He said, see this little boy, this child. This child is innocent, doesn't know about power and glory. He just wants to be loved. He wants to love others, serve his parents with honor, and be part of society. And he just wants to be happy. This boy knows God in a deeper way than you, because you've lost sight of who God really is. You have to be like him once more. Let go of all the vanity. Let go of all the power. You don't need to take that with you into discipleship. This is what Jesus is saying. When I was training to be a priest, yes, I went to Rome, and being in Rome, the heart of the eternal city, sometimes I forgot myself and embraced vanity, because I was young and I was good looking and I was studying in Rome, so I had it all, didn't I? But when I came home, my parish priest, my parents and my friends made sure that they brought me right down to reality, that I was nothing more than Robbie, nothing special. But I learned academia, and I learned how to pray, and I learned the church history, and I learned all sorts of things, and I learned how to be open to God. But it was on the day of my ordination in 2008 that my journey as a priest really started, because I realized on the day of my ordination that people will want me to be a man of God. I better start praying. They will want me to be a servant of the servants. Well, I better start helping people. And it's a bit like when we learn to drive. We can be told all the things of what we need to do, the three-point turns, the emergency stops, the left and rights, the speed limit. We can have all of this. But we all remember when we passed our test and we parked outside our house with our first car or borrowed car, and we got to the end of the street and we didn't know whether it was we were going to left or right, because for the beginning, we had to, of course, think for ourselves. Yes, some of you here didn't need to do that, because some of you here, of course, had a man with a red flag in front of your car, and he guided you. But in my day, I had to use my own thought process. So, of course, it's really important to know that we can learn lots of things, but to move in the direction of Jesus, we need to put on Christ. We need to live like him, pray like him, love like him, serve like him. And that doesn't come automatically. We are, of course, constantly learning in our lives, so that hopefully when we do get to the Father's house and we meet God face to face, he will say, "Well done with your journey. Well done with opening your heart to my Son. Now you're ready for the shop floor." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Shall we stand and pray? Shall we say the Nicene Creed together? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. Our pilgrimage on earth enables us to share the path that Jesus walked, and we endure suffering like he did. We remember his sacrifice for us, knowing that it brought him glory, and that it will do the same for us.
May the whole church be guided and governed by the Holy Spirit. Let all Christians be led into the way of truth and hold their faith in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that peace and love may reign in the world, that justice and dignity may prevail in our time, and that all creation may live in unity and harmony. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the young people who returned to their studies recently, that they may see God's guiding hand at work in their lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those struggling with their faith, that they may open their hearts to God's grace and turn to the Lord with renewed love and commitment. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the homeless and all those displaced by family strife, domestic violence, and mental health issues. May God's mercy and compassion create an end to their plight. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all the deceased members of our parish and those whose anniversaries occur in this coming week. May the souls of all the faithful departed
through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray, we ask our Mother Mary, Queen of Peace, to intercede for us as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Merciful Father, your love for us surpasses all our hopes and desires. Forgive our failings, keep us in your peace and lead us in the way of salvation. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Would you like to be seated as we prepare our altar this morning? Shall we sing hymn number 511? Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive with favour, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Keeping our prayers, yourselves and your families, here on earth and in heaven. We also keep in our prayers, especially those people in the world who are suffering because of war and of famine. We ask the Lord to bring them protection, healing and help. Our mass intentions this morning. Firstly, the Castro family would like to remember the repose of the soul of Alex Castro. It's the anniversary of his birthday today. So we keep the Castro family in our prayers, and they have friends and family here today at Mass. We also pray for the repose of the souls of Ambrose and Margaret Holland, and we ask the Lord to be with them as well. Today also, this afternoon, we'll be praying for the repose of the soul of Sister Eileen Keating. Sister Eileen was the provincial of the Presentation Sisters and lived up at the convent. And so we ask the Lord to be with Sister Eileen, who died just over a week ago. Next Sunday will be her Requiem Mass. So we ask the Lord to be with Alex, Ambrose, Margaret and Eileen in the banquet. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so love the world, and in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost to disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please be seated or kneel. Eucharistic prayer 2. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Patrick our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants today, Alex Castro on this his birthday anniversary, and Ambrose and Margaret Holland. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. With a bow or a handshake, let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. body of Christ, Pat. The blood of Christ. In a moment, myself and Pat will distribute Holy Communion. The precious blood is available also this morning. We also have gluten-free. If you're gluten-free, let me know as you come forward. If you don't normally receive communion in the Catholic Church, still come forward. Just put your arm across your chest, and that will let me know you want a blessing. It would be my great honour to give you a Sunday blessing this morning. And before that, shall we send a blessing of communion to those, spiritual blessing of communion, to those who are watching online today. Dear Father in heaven, we ask you to be with our sick, our housebound, our parishioners, and those watching from around the world. Let us walk beside Jesus, listen to him, and open our hearts that we may be his missionary disciples in the world. And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you wait in your pew today, our welcomers will guide you. We come in a certain order. So if you're a visitor today, just wait in your pew and you'll be guided forward. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Be right with you, okay? The body of Christ. Would you like the chalice? Yeah. She'd like the chalice, yeah. Body of Christ, Bernard. Body of Christ. Would you like the chalice? I like your hair. Very nice. Your hair looks lovely. Just one or two notices today. Thank you very much for your continuing financial support of your parish. In the next couple of weeks, I'll be meeting with our joint finance committee. So Lucinda in our office, she's just finished the financial returns of HACCP and Matlock separately. And so I'll be reporting them to the finance committee, and then eventually I'll report them to yourself. So mid-October, you will, please God, you will be reported on the finances and so on. Just to let you know that. If you keep in your diary, there's a Carmelite day. Joe Gilbert is running a Carmelite day here at Matlock. It's being advertised across the diocese. And so a day to learn, of course, about Mount Carmel and all the great saints of the Carmelites. So that's available to you in the coming weeks. We also say a big thank you. We had an open last weekend. We had an information weekend, and we thank those for our parish pastoral council and also all of the different ministries of our church. We thank those who set up stalls and let you know more information. And those two, also we had one and two volunteers as well to partake in the parish, volunteering as well. So thank you for that. It was well attended at all the masses. If you wish to have me to order you a Sunday Missal for your own use, then of course email me this week and I will make sure that I add you to the order. You just have to let me know whether it's red or blue. And of course, I know where you live. I'll get the money out of you some other time. We have a retiring collection this morning, and that is for Home Mission Sunday. Home Mission Sunday, of course, is to spread the good news of the gospel throughout England, Wales, and Scotland, and so on. So it's spreading the word in our own country through the bishops of England and Wales. So if you want to support that work, helping people to enter our church, advertising, all sorts of different things, then please be generous on the way out today. Everything else is in your bulletin, so that's great. We thank Amanda for our organ. We have our altar servers as well, and you welcome us and those who work in the background, cleaning our church and maintaining our buildings. So thank you for that as well. There is an information about the new lectionary. The words of the readings are slightly going to change slightly, and that's why we're going to be having new lectionaries. And that leaflet's quite useful to read in regards to updating you about why it's happened and how the process works and so on. So that's available for you to read in your bulletin today. Shall we stand and pray? Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our lives. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. There is a tea and coffee in our parish hall this morning. And so please, if you want to come in, there's fresh percolated coffee, biscuits galore. I'll let you think about this on the way home today. When I was 16 and I started as a watchmaker, there used to be a canteen in my factory, watchmaking factory. And after my first day at work, I went home and my mum said, "How was your first day at work?" And I said, "It was amazing, brilliantly. But you'll never guess, the ladies who serve in the canteen, they swear like troopers, mum." And of course, I hadn't heard people swearing as much as in the factory setting. So of course, I learned some new words and vocabulary as a trainee. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. So with great gusto, we're going to be singing hymn number 188. 188.
Mass is ended, children of the Lord. Take his word to others, as you've heard it spoken to you. Go, the Mass is ended, go and tell the world. The Lord is good, the Lord is kind, and he loves everyone. Go, the Mass is ended, take his love to all. Gladden all who meet you, fill their hearts with hope and courage. Go, the Mass is ended, the world with love, and give to all what you receive, the peace and joy of Christ. Go, the Mass is ended, strengthened in the Lord. Every burden, spread the joy of Christ around you. Go, the Mass is ended, take his word to all. His name is yours, to finish the world, to make...